गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, द नेम ऑफ दिस टॉपिक इज हाइट एंड डिस्टेंस। दिस टॉपिक इज ऑल्सो ए पार्ट ऑफ कंसेप्ट ऑफ ट्रिग्नोमेट्री। इन दिस टॉपिक वी अप्लाई द ट्रिग्नोमेट्री इन डेली लाइफ प्रॉब्लम्स। इन दिस कंसेप्ट वी हैव टू टाइप ऑफ एंगल्स। द फर्स्ट वन इज एंगल ऑफ एलिवेशन, द फर्स्ट इज नोन एज एंगल ऑफ एलिवेशन, and the second is known as angle of depression. We use two type of angles here. The first is known as angle of elevation and the second one is known as angle of depression. When I look at this structure, suppose a man is standing at this point, he is looking at the top of the building. A man is standing at this point and from here to here he looks at the top of the building and he finds this angle to be theta degree. Now, this angle is known as angle of elevation. What do you mean by the term angle of elevation? When a man stands at a base and he looks at the top, the angle made by the man with this base is known as angle of elevation. On the other hand, when man stands at this point and he looks at this point, the angle made by with this base is known as angle of depression. This angle is known as angle of depression. Means when angle of elevation is given, it means you are standing at the base and you are looking at the top. On the other hand, when angle of depression is given, it means you are standing at the top and you are looking at the base. So this is angle of elevation and this is known as angle of depression. Value-wise, both angles are same because these two surfaces are parallel. Both are known as alternate angles, so we can say both are said to be same. Now in this topic, we have some standard practical problems. I will discuss one by one, try to make the figure in your mind because all these questions are primarily based on the figures. If you can easily draw the figures, you can easily answer your questions. So I am going to start with one by one. It is given that a man is standing at this point and he looks at the top of the building and he finds that angle of elevation to be equal to 30 degree. Suppose a man is standing at a point A and from that point there was a building BC. From that point he looks at the top of the building and he finds that angle of elevation to be 30 degree. Then he moves, after that he moves 20 meters towards the building. He moves 20 meters towards the building, right? And he reaches at a point D. Means this length is given as 20 meters. And now we observe that his angle of elevation has become equal to 60 degree. Means earlier from a point where he was standing from point A, he observed that angle of elevation to be 30 degree. After going 20 meters towards the building, he finds that this angle of elevation to be 60 degree. Now based on this question, we have to find out what is the height of the building. What is height of the building? Based on this, we have to find out what is the height of the building, right? Means I have to find the length of BC. If I assume this to be H and this to be X, so we have two triangles. First is in triangle BCD, I can say perpendicular upon base, H upon X is equal to tangent theta, tangent 60, which is equal to root 3. Or else we can say H upon X is equal to root 3. Then we can take this triangle ABC. We can take the full triangle ABC. Here I can say perpendicular upon base. So we can say H upon X plus 20 equal to tangent of 30 degree. Tangent 30 is 1 by root 3. Or else I can say H upon X plus 20 equal to 1 upon root 3. Now we have made two equations. First one is this one and second is this one. I have to find the value of H. For that, what I can say, I can divide both, or I can just put the values of x to be equal, means h is equal to x root 3. we can say that h is equal to x root 3, and from here I can say h equal to x plus 20 upon root 3. That would be taken as x plus 20 upon root 3. Cross multiply, that would be 3x equal to x plus 20, or I can say this 2x equal to 20, or x equals to 10, right? Now when x is equal to 10, I have to find h height. The height is taken as 10 root 3. That becomes your answer. Right? Now one thing you can infer, one thing should be noted as a shortcut method. In any question where this angle is 30 and this is 60, it's a standard result. If this is 30 and this is 60, whatever the length of this, this length would always be half of this one. If this is 20, that must be 10. Means if you have any question of this type, if you have this angle to be 30 and this to be 60, right? What you can say, if this is 20, this must be 10, this is 40, this must be 20, because that will always be half, right? So if this is 20, that will be 10, and after that we can apply here trigonometry, so h is said to be 10 root 3, that becomes your answer. I hope this is clear. Now after this we will take the second statement in which we have a slab over the top of the building. There was a building and man is standing at this point A, building height is BC, and man looks at the top of the building. It is given that man looks at the top of the building. He finds that his angle of elevation to be 30 degree. He finds his angle of elevation to be 30 degree. Means there was a man, when he looks at the top of the building, he finds that angle of elevation to be 30 degree. There is a flag on the top of the building. On the top of the building there was a flag. Suppose this point is D. When the man looks at the top of the flag, he finds that this angle of elevation to be 45 degree. Means when a man looks at the top of the building, that is point C, he finds that angle of elevation to be 30 degree. When he looks at the top of the flag, point D, he finds that angle of elevation to be 45 degree. Now the question is, if length of the flag is 8 feet, we have to find out what is the height of the building. The question is, if length of the flag is 8 feet, so we have to find out what is the height of the building, right? Now in this statement, what is given to us? It is given that the length of CD is equal to 8. We have to find the length of BC. So I can assume BC to be H and AB to be X. Similarly, we have two triangles, triangle ABC, H upon X. We can say this H upon X is equal to tangent 30, which is equal to 1 upon root 3. So I can say h upon x equal to 1 upon root 3. That is tangent 30. In the second case, this angle is 45. So I can say x plus 8 upon x. So we can say x plus 8 upon x equal to tangent 45. And tangent 45 is equal to 1. So we can say h plus 8 equal to x. H equal to x plus 8. And from here I can say h equal to x root. Now we can make this both equal and we can find the value of x. How? X plus 8 equal to x root 3. X will go there. 8 equal to x into my root 3 minus 1. Or I can say x equal to 8 upon root 3 minus 1. That would be taken as root 3 plus 1 upon root 3 plus 1. Or I can say 8 into root 3 plus 1 upon 3 minus 1, 2. 2 will go on 4. My answer is said to be 4 into may root 3 plus 1, that becomes my answer. So that is the value of x. I have to find x, and x is taken as x root 3. So finally we can say our h equals to x root 3, or we can say x plus 8. Either I can put the value here or at this point, in both cases my answer would be there. So I can say 4 root 3 into root 3 plus 1, that is the height of the building. I hope the point is clear. The question is quite similar as we have done earlier. The point is very simple. Two triangles are made and we have to put our values and we have to find the value of h. Then we have third type of problem. Suppose it is given that there are two buildings, both are standing parallel on the same base. Two buildings are there. A man is standing at the base of the smaller building and he looks at the top of the bigger building, and this angle of elevation is given as 60 degree. One man stands at the base of the smaller building and from here he looks at the top of the bigger building. He finds that angle of elevation to be 60 degree. Similarly, when the man stands at this point and he looks at the top of the bigger building, he finds that angle of elevation to be 30 degree. These two informations are given. What is given to you? Suppose when a man stands at the base of the smaller building and he looks at the top of the bigger building, he finds the angle of elevation to be 60 degree. When he stands here 30, he finds that angle to be 30. It is given that if height of the smaller building is 20 meters, we have to find out what is the height of bigger building. Question is, if height of smaller building is 20 meters, based on that we have to find the height of the bigger building. Now how you can answer this type of statement, what is the process? Just pay attention here. What I can say, I have to find this total height. If I assume this to be A, B, C, D, E, that to be X, this is 20. If I assume CD to be X, then BC, then B is also equal to X. Now two triangles are made. First one is triangle ABE. In triangle ABE, I can say H upon X is equal to tangent 30. In triangle ABE, we can say H upon X is equal to tangent of 30, which is equal to 1 upon root 3. So I can say X upon root 3. That's the first association. Secondly, I can make it in triangle ACD. In triangle ACD, I can take it as X plus 20 upon X is equal to tangent 60, which is equal to root 3. So from here I can say X plus 20 equal to X root 3. I have to find the value of X. I can compare both X. Here I can say X equal to H root 3. From here I can say X plus 20 upon root 3 equal to X. Since both are equal, we can make both to be equal. Cross multiply 3H equal to X plus 20, or we can say 2H equal to 20 and H is equal to 10. Right? That is equal to 10. If this is 10, it is 20. The total height of the building is 30. So we can say the height of the bigger building is 30 meters. That becomes your answer. That is also taken on the same way. This is 30, this is 60. It means this would be half of this one. This 20, this would be 10. So I can say 20 plus 10 equal to 30. Pay attention here what we have done. Two angles are given. We have made two type of triangles. First is triangle ABE. Second is triangle ACD. We have just put our aspects in such a way. And from here I can say H is 10 and I am in a position to get my answer. After this, we have fourth type of problem. Suppose this is a very standard question. One tree is given to you. It is given that the tree was broken at a place because of the wind, and the remaining part tilted in such a way so that this is the top of this, and this angle made is equal to 30 degree, right? If the distance between top of the tree and base is 10 feet, we have to find out what was the actual height of the tree. If this is angle is 30 degree, on that basis we have to find out what is the actual height of the tree. In this statement, it is given that this angle is 30 degree and the distance between the top of the tree and the base is equal to 10 feet, we have to find the height. If I assume this is x and this is y, so first I can take, and that is equal to 10. So I can say x upon 10 equal to tangent of 30. Tangent 30 is 1 by root 3. So I can say x equal to 10 upon root 3. That's the first case. In the second case, I can say that is base, this is hypotenuse, b upon h, 10 upon y equal to cos 30. Cos 30 equals to root 3 by 2. So I can say the value of the y is equal to 20 upon root 3. Right? We have to find the height of it. So I can say the total length of the tree is equal to x plus y, 20 upon root 3 plus 10 upon root 3, and our answer is said to be 30 upon root 3. That is taken as the height of the tree. So we can say this is the total length of the tree. One more statement that states you, a person is standing at a point and one aeroplane was flying at a height of 2 kilometers from the earth. Means this height is given as 2 kilometers, and the person observes that angle of elevation to be 60 degrees. Right? Then it is given that after 10 minutes that angle of elevation became 30 degrees at the same height. After 10 minutes, angle of elevation had become equal to 30 degrees at the same height. We have to find out what is the speed of the aeroplane in kilometer per hour. Pay attention here, what is given to you. An aeroplane was flying at a height of 2 kilometer above the ground. At that time, the angle of elevation is to be 60 degrees. Then it is given that after 10 minutes that angle of elevation is equal to 30 degrees and aeroplane was at the same height, we have to find the what is the speed of the aeroplane. Now if I take these numbers as A, B, C, this is D, this is E. For answering my question, what I need length of AD, it is the distance travelled by the aeroplane in 10 minutes. How I can go for it? First I can take that to be x, so I can say this 2 upon CB, that is BC, is equal to tangent of 60. So 2 upon BC equal to root 3, so we can say BC equal to 2 upon root 3. Then I will find CE, this is also 2, so I can say 2 upon CE equal to tangent of 30. That is 1 upon root 3, so 2 upon CE is equal to 1 upon root 3, or I can say CE is equal to 2 root 3. Now I need AD, that is same as to BE, so we can say that VE is equal to CE minus BC, that BE is equal to CE minus CB, so I can say CE minus CB. So this would be equal to 2 root 3. Minus 2 upon root 3, just take the LCM, so that would be 6 minus 2 upon root 3, so I can say this is 4 upon root 3. It is a distance. I have to find the speed. 10 meter would be taken as 1 by 6 hours. Speed is always equal to distance upon time, so we can say 4 upon root 3 upon time 1 by 6. That would go on the upside, so I can say our answer is 24 upon root 3 kilometer per hour. That becomes the speed of the aeroplane. Pay attention here, what we need this length AD, right? How I can go for AD? AD would be taken as CE minus CB, right? So then I can say that would be 4 upon root 3, and here the length is 4 upon root 3 and the time is equal to 1 by 6 hours, so I can say the distance upon time is equal to speed. So speed would be taken as 14 upon root 3 km per hour. This becomes our answer. Similarly, we have one more problem. Suppose it is given that there was a building and there was an insect at this point. When the insect looks at the top of the building, he finds that this angle of elevation equal to 45 degree. When this insect looks at the top of the building, he finds that this angle of elevation is 45 degree. That insect started to fly towards the top at an angle of elevation of 30 degree. That insect started to fly towards the top at an angle of elevation of 30 degree, right? After going for 100 meters, that insect has flown for 100 meters and it be at a point. From this point, that insect observed that now this angle has become equal to 60 degree, right? Based on this, we have to find out what is the height of the building. Pay attention here, what I have stated you. From this point to the top, insect observed that angle of elevation to be 45 degree. He flew at an angle of 30 degree. For 100 meters, he would be at this point. From here, he observed that now this angle of elevation has become equal to 60 degree. On that basis, I have to find out what is the height of the building. Suppose if I take to be A, B, C, D, E and F. First, I will try to find this value FD as well as DE. So I can say, we know that any side opposite to 30 is always half of hypotenuse. So I can say this FD would be equal to 50. That property I stated in 30, 60, 90. Or you can also apply perpendicular upon hypotenuse, sine 30. Now this is 100, this is 50. I can apply Pythagoras here for finding the DE, or I can go for the simple concept 50, that is 30. So I can say DF upon DE equal to tangent of 30. Then DF is 50, so I can say 50 upon DE, tan 30 is 1 by root 3, or we can say DE is equal to 50 and root 3. Means this is 50 root 3, right? Now the next point I can say, if I assume the total height to be h, AC equal to h. So I can say AC upon CE is equal to tangent of 45, which is equal to 1. So I can say AC equal to CE is same as to h. Means this is h and this is equal to h. Now I can say this is 50. From here to here, that will also be 50. Or I can say this AB is said to be h minus 50. Similarly, this is h, this is 50 root 3, so this would be taken as h minus 50 root 3, or I can say this BF is h minus 50 root 3. I can say this value of this BF is equal to h minus 50 root 3. Now, in this triangle, in triangle ABF, now I can say in triangle ABF, what I can say? I can state that AB upon BF is always equal to tangent 60. We can say h minus 50 upon h minus 50 root 3 is equal to tangent 60, that is said to be root 3. I will cross multiply, so I will get it as h minus 50 equal to root 3h minus 150. This will come here, 100 equal to h will be taken as common, root 3 minus 1. So h is taken as 100 upon root 3 minus 1 multiplied root 3 plus 1 upon root 3 plus 1. So this would be taken as 100 into root 3 plus 1 upon 2. My final answer is equal to 50 into root 3 plus 1. That becomes my answer. Pay attention here, what we have done. We have to find the total height. I have taken this AC to be h. That angle is 45. We know that 1045 is equal to 1. It means AC is same as to CE. That is 1045. Right? After that, by the 30, 60, 90 triangle, if this is 100, this is 50, that would be 50 root 3. Or we can also use trigonometry here. Now if this is h, this is 50 root 3. So this portion is taken as h minus 50 root 3. And if total is h, this is 50. This is taken as h minus 50. Now in this triangle ABF, I have this side in the terms of h, that we have in the terms of h, so I can say AP upon BF is equal to tangent of 60, right? Tan 60 is equal to root 3. Now I can just solve this equation, and from here I can find the value of h, which is equal to 50 into root 3 plus 1. That becomes my answer. I hope the concept is clear. So these are some different types of questions that are a part of the concept of height and distance.